Everybody want to know who are you, okay? Really, the question we want to know ourselves, okay? Okay, so the most important thing is we support basic science.
In technology.
From plant science to
biophysics.
In the area of the brain research.
To study small molecules.
Orchids with different lengths of nectar spurs.
Behavior research.
And even cancer.
I have said too much already.
An HFSP-like project is a project which asks a new question. If this project will be successful, there will be a new view onto the field. It will never be the same afterwards. That's what they have in common. When the project is completed, the world will never be the same.
So HFSP got involved at a really crucial stage, actually. So I was working on Drosophila development as a postdoc in the Imperial Cancer Research Fund. And I became interested in this gene hedgehog.
And this, the researcher group discovered signaling molecule, sonic hedgehog.
It turns out that this is a very crucial for various disease and cancer and cell growth. And therefore suddenly people got interested in this apparently very esoteric project.
My motivation is just understanding basic processes. But I think what our discoveries have led to in terms of the development of, ultimately the development of an anti-cancer drug is a justification for doing basic research.
The beauty of science that you don't know before what is going to be important in the future. You know, studying life is a very difficult type of study. So the Inhuman Frontier Science Program, what we do is to try to put together scientists that have come from a different background.
The HFSP experience was really influential for me. It showed me just how exciting interdisciplinary collaboration can be. By collaborating with people in different fields, you get an entirely different angle on the same problem, and that often gives you a completely different answer from the one you were expecting. In my current research, it's primarily about animal pollination on flowers. Now, I can be an expert on the petal and how it makes its different structures and how those structures look. But what I can't be an expert on is how they look to an insect, which has a different visual system from me. I can't be an expert on how the properties of the petal affect the behavior of light. And so I also need to collaborate with physicists, optical physicists. And by putting all that together, I can really get a feel for what my petal's doing. Otherwise, I'm really just, you know, saying what I think I can see. And that's not a very scientific approach.
It is hard to explain, but we are not trying to just distribute the money globally. The emphasis on the intercontinentality is from the idea that a different continent has a different approach in solving some problems.
We believe in young scientists, that they have a completely free mind, and we believe in their early independence.
Traditionally, you establish your own lab and then you continue sort of doing the things that you did as a postdoc. The HFSP funding gave us the opportunity to both do something completely different that we'd never done before, do a project that we had no real preliminary data for, a real blue skies project, if you like, and to really have the opportunity to try that at a stage where no other funding agency, I think, would really have given us that chance.
And I mean, the result is amazing. I mean, last year, first week of October, Nobel week, 5 of the 6 Nobel Prizes in chemistry and in medicine, 5 of them were people who had been funded years before 10, 15 years before by HFSP. So somehow this philosophy seems to work.
I remember quite distinctly when HFSP was founded and the astonishing direction that HFSP laid out, and was truly unique at the time, quite inspiring, quite exciting, and it has proved to live up to, I think, our greatest hopes.